Welcome back to Weekly Top 10 of Everything. The Amazon is one of the planet's last great wildernesses, but legends have circulated for centuries that lost cities existed deep within the forests. A remarkable and vast lost city with pyramids has been found in an impossible-to-access Amazon jungle. Researchers used a technology called LiDAR, which was able to see through objects or surfaces, and they were successfully able to uncover the lost city in Bolivia. So in this video, we're going to talk about the ancient pyramid found in the Amazon. The video is going to be amazingly informative, so make sure you stick to the end. The ruins of a vast ancient civilization that has remained hidden under the densely forested landscape of the Bolivian Amazon for centuries has now been mapped out in unprecedented detail, reports a new study. The immense settlements stretch across some 80 square miles of the Llanos de Mojos region of Bolivia and include pyramids, causeways, canals, ramparts, elevated forest islands, and buildings arranged in ways that hint at a cosmological worldview. The cities, built by the Casareb communities between 500 and 1400 AD, are located in the Llanos de Mojos Savannah Forest, Bolivia, and have been hidden under the thick tree canopies for centuries. They feature an array of elaborate and intricate structures unlike any previously discovered in the region, including 16-feet-high terraces covering 54 acres, the equivalent of 30 football pitches, and 69-foot-tall conical pyramids. It's very difficult to make such a discovery in dense forests, but through new technology, it has been detected. These surprising results have been obtained with the technology of laser mapping. A laser mapping device was installed on the helicopter, and it was carried over several parts of the forest. The device yielded a 3D image that did not have trees and could predict the exact contours of the land. This new discovery has also weakened the notion that it lacked sophisticated societies before European colonization in the 16th century. But it has shown that an advanced civilization lived here. From the helicopter, a LiDAR system fires down a grid of infrared beams, hundreds of thousands per second, and when each beam strikes something on the Earth's surface, it bounces back with a measure of distance. This produces an enormous cloud of data points, which can be fed into computer software that creates high-resolution images in which scientists can digitally deforest the Amazon. By scrubbing away trees, the maps reveal the Earth's surface and its archaeological features on it. The aerial view with trees stripped away revealed two centers, each anchored by a large network of regional settlements connected by numerous causeways. Those passageways radiate out from the centers like spokes on a wheel and stretch for several miles. These connect suburban settlements, ranging from small settlements closer to the centers to more distant and even smaller sites that may have been used as temporary campsites. Similarly, canals also stretch from the main centers and connect to rivers and Laguna San Jose, which apparently delivered water to Cotoca. The research has revealed that ancient Amazonians built and lived in densely populated towns with 22-meter-tall clay pyramids surrounded by kilometers of elevated pathways. This was about 1,500 years ago. In total, the researchers uncovered two new big settlement sites named Cotoca and Lanfar, and 24 minor sites, 15 of which were previously unknown. And the complexity of the previously unknown settlements is apparently mind-blowing, according to team researcher Hiko Prumers, an archaeologist at the German Archaeological Institute. It's a myth that was created by Europeans who really spoke of a jungle and vast regions untouched by humans, he says. So a lot of people didn't want to see that there were archaeological sites here that merit exploration. I'm sure that in the next 10 or 20 years, we'll see a lot of these cities, and some even bigger than the ones we're presenting in our paper, he adds. Michael Hackenberger, an anthropologist at the University of Florida, wasn't involved in the research, but has been studying urbanism in the pre-Columbian Amazon for nearly two decades. He notes that the elements of the settlement at Llanos de Mojos, like moats and causeways, and a modified landscape of parklands, working forests, and fish farms, have been seen elsewhere in the ancient Amazon. But the new research unveils something quite new. Previous examples of urbanism in the Amazon include the upper Xinghu region of the Brazilian Amazon, where Hackenberger works with the Cucuro Nation. Such settlements might be described as groups of villages networked together. They aren't technically urban, some experts have argued, but because they lack clearly defined larger centers with monumental architecture like platform mounds and U-shaped temples. But those urban centers can be found at Llanos de Mojos. This is, in my mind, the clearest case of a fully urbanized Amazonian landscape, Heckenberger notes. It's a marvelous piece of work. It shows a really remarkable range of things that humans did in the past to work with their landscapes and work with larger and larger populations. And it's thanks to a British explorer named Colonel Percy Fawcett, who in 1952 originally went on a mission to find the city of Z in the uncharted Amazon. He had packed rifles, machetes, and a ukulele and went about on his trek. The explorer was adamant that there was a fallen civilization, and he was convinced he would find the last great blank space in the world. He was convinced the lost city of Z existed and had followed his trail in order to prove he was right. Tragically, Percy never returned, and no one ever knew if he found the lost city of Z, with the skull of the British explorer reportedly found many years later. But now his efforts have been vindicated after new technology has revealed the vast jungle on the edge of the Amazon. Until now, much of the jungle had been blocked by trees, plants, and greenery for centuries, and any efforts to try and access the jungle were virtually impossible, but modern technology has now remarkably changed that. The architectural layout of large settlement sites of the Kasarab culture indicates that the inhabitants of this region created a new social and public landscape through monumentality, Prumers and his colleagues said in the study. We propose that Kasarab culture settlement system is a singular form of tropical agrarian low-density urbanism to our knowledge, the first known case for the entire tropical lowlands of South America. The international team of researchers from the UK and Germany also found a vast network of reservoirs, causeways, and checkpoints spanning several miles. The discovery challenges the view of Amazonia as a historically pristine landscape, the researchers say, showing it was instead home to an early urbanism created and managed by indigenous populations for thousands of years. We long suspected that the most complex pre-Columbian societies in the whole basin developed in this part of the Bolivian Amazon, but the evidence is concealed under the forest canopy and is hard to visit in person, said Jose Arrarte from the University of Exeter. Our LIDAR system has revealed built terraces, straight causeways, enclosures with checkpoints, and water reservoirs. There are monumental structures just a mile apart, connected by 600 miles of canals, long raised causeways connecting sites, reservoirs, and lakes. Chris Fisher says that till now, the way we used to see the civilization settled in the Amazon is quite different from it. Fisher further said that until now, it was believed that the people living here lived in small groups with limited social development and agriculture. But the discovery of these places has changed the perception. This tells us that these were not small tribes, but cities. In 2019, researchers from Germany and Britain scanned an area of 77 square miles with helicopters. 26 settlements have been discovered in Bolivia, of which 11 were not yet known. While it appears that the Amazon once teemed with human activity, many ancient sites have remained almost undisturbed for some 500 years, something Prumer cites as a big advantage. But the Amazon is changing rapidly. Forests are being eliminated to promote farming, ranching, energy production, and the roads and dams that support such efforts. Many of those undisturbed areas, with their hidden records of past cultures, won't remain so for long. Fisher advocates for large-scale LIDAR scanning of the Amazon and far beyond through an Earth Archive project aimed at capturing what remains of the past before it's lost to the future. Let us know your opinion in the comments section below. This was all for today. Hope you liked the video. Do not forget to subscribe to Weekly Top 10 of Everything to see new videos weekly. Stay safe, and we will be back soon with another video.